The Wedding Planner, brought to you by Rogers Jewelers.
Sandra Hadley joins us now. You know those magazines say what's hot, what's not, what's in, what's out?
Like out, Heidi Klum. We're channeling Heidi
Project
Klum.
Project Runway.
That's right.
Okay, so you're going to tell us what traditions people are keeping, what ones are
I really want to talk about what is out, the traditions, wedding traditions that people typically do. Okay, number one, bouquet and garter toss.
I would say it's in, but it's optional.
Well, you know, it's really going out. I have a lot more clients where they're saying, we're just going to eliminate that entire tradition.
Why?
Because I think, you know, it depends on the guests that are there. They may have too many married people. I think it just kind of seems to fall on itself. It's becoming antiquated.
And like, what does it even mean? Who cares?
None of the guys want to catch the garter. They'll stand there like this, really stiff, far away.
All the girls are to be, come on, just go up there if you're with a
date. It doesn't mean that if you still like to do that, that you're, you know, it's just a tradition that's going out.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. See, I'm so out of the loop. What's new? Okay, the guest book.
Yes, that's going out as well. It's something you come in, you sign your name. Half of the people don't even get to sign it because you close the book 10 minutes before the ceremony starts.
And then it ends up in a closet.
Yeah, it ends up at the reception. They forget to sign it, and you never look at it again. Instead, people are going for scrapbooks or photos or like little pieces of paper to leave specialized notes, which means a lot more than signing Mr. and Mrs. Jane Smith.
So you get the specialized notes and like...
At the reception.
And put it in a big book.
Yes.
Okay.
Something like that. There's a lot of different options.
And I have seen that picture one where they have it like, it's like you write it
it's
on
a
the
mat.
Matting.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And then that's fun to look at. But a guest book, my guest book, 14 years, still closed, dusty somewhere. I don't know where it is.
Really?
You'll never look at it again. It's just silly.
That's a really good point. Okay.
Save yourself
$50. That's true. What about the whole tradition of not seeing the groom, not seeing the bride before the wedding?
Not seeing each other before the wedding, out. They are seeing each other.
Man, all these standbys.
They're seeing each other and getting their pictures done.
When they look the best.
I'm gonna tell you, this, first of all, most important day of your life, it's between the two of you getting married. Why do you spend half that day trying not to see each other? You should be together. Mm-hmm. And you get these pictures. I've done it with and I've done it without. The weddings that the groom and the bride see each other, I can't express it. There's a different vibe to the wedding.
Really?
I don't want to say that it's relaxed, because they do separate again before the ceremony, but it's just they're more into each other.
Yeah, they're a little more comfortable with the whole thing.
Yes, they're a little more comfortable. It's taken that edge off, not the excitement. You haven't dampened that.
Right.
But by the time they come to the reception, it's not so rushed and hurried. I can't explain it. It's just a different vibe.
That is interesting to me. So you say...
I highly recommend it.
What was the folklore behind that anyway? Just they just wanted to build up the anticipation?
I think so. And remember, that was the first time they ever... The tradition was the first time they ever saw them.
That's true.
Because it was arranged marriages. So it has nothing to do with...
So very antiquated.
Very.
All right.
Moving on.
Next is the champagne toast.
Champagne toast. Mm-hmm. Champagne, I have filled beer, 7-Up, fruit juice, wine in those champagne flutes. Everything almost but champagne.
Diet Coke?
They didn't care. I said, do whatever you want. Most people don't like champagne. And also, if you do a champagne toast for the entire reception, most people don't like it. So they go, they take a little sip. You spent all that money. It's out.
I'm digging that. Alfita saying, I love it. So you can say goodbye to these things, and you're also really saying hello to some money that's now in your pocket.
Right.
Fabulous ideas. You got to kind of rethink the modern wedding.
That's right.
What this is all about. Fox 7's wedding planner, Sandra Hadley. Thanks so much. We will see you next week. We'll see you after a quick break.